Now Dr. Mukesh Kumar.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mukesh. I come from University of Cambridge, Department of Engineering. And Professor Ravi, Dr. Bhujangra, Dr. Baldev Raj, Professor Tiwari, they asked me to come here. And their wish is my command, so that's why I'm here. So I've been asked to talk about digital platform. And I thought, like, why not actually I should talk something with where I work, which is looking at digital supply chains perspective on inclusive manufacturing. Before even I start talking about inclusive manufacturing, one of the things that we need to understand in which context we are talking about. Currently, the world is changing. And why it's changing? Because there are great inequality that exists. Because of these great inequality, what do we see right now is last year we had Brexit in US, in UK, and then we had Trump in US. And all these things are creating, it's being created because there's a huge dissatisfaction of greater inequality in our society. And because of that, we are focusing on inclusive manufacturing in order to reduce those global inequality or tackle the poverty. And that's the understanding that I have for inclusive manufacturing. This is the example that I want to present. It's this case study I done in 2013 in Maharashtra, looking at Maha Grapes. The Maha Grapes is a company which was banned to export their grapes to EU because their product had harmful chemicals like arsenic, and it's coming because of arsenic water that existed in that particular locality. So these 3,000 farmers were earning really, really less money. They didn't know where they can send their product. And within India, they were getting less value. What they did is they imported some technologies for actually having a mineral water from Spain. They imported some technology from California for having organic compost. And all these technologies, and with various other training programs and certifications, what they actually managed to do is their product quality has improved, and they were able to export to European Union, including UK. I can go on all these practices that they have followed, but one thing that we have to take in account that this is the way one created an inclusive manufacturing activity, if we consider agriculture is a manufacturing activity. So where the farmers are getting more value out of their product, and they are having a better livelihood. What we have to actually understand here, one data that actually I didn't tell you, is these farmers are still drinking arsenic water. So is this inclusive manufacturing? Are we looking inclusive manufacturing in entirety? And that's the question that we need to ask. So this is just one example. And looking at this inclusive manufacturing, then we need to understand what are the key dimensions that we need to follow. And in Cambridge, in IFM, we have a word called manufacturing a better world. And within the manufacturing a better world, we have a theme going on, which is called manufacturing for inclusive growth. And this is the few academics who sat down and think about what are the key themes that might contribute to inclusive manufacturing. And what you look at, various themes that is mentioned in the box, and the three main key themes are redistributed manufacturing, inclusive innovation, sustainable system. And I think all these words that I actually mentioned here, I'm sure most of these words covered in this particular IMF event today in various forms. What actually key objectives are? We are looking at promoting global prosperity, we are looking at thinking about sustainability, we are thinking about infrastructure, which is a resilient as well, and at the end, tackling global poverty. So this particular framework that we are currently using in order to develop our thinking and what are the key themes that outcomes from each themes can be contributing it. At the end, what we are looking at, what kind of capability and capacity we need to develop in order to address this particular challenge. If somebody is thinking about inclusive manufacturing is an Indian challenge, I might disagree with that. Again, I was giving you a Brexit and Trump example before. It's a developed world challenge. It's a global challenge, frankly speaking. So every country is struggling in different form. Because I need to talk about the digital supply chain, so supply chain of framework is there. You look at the focal company, within the focal company there is a short supply chain, a small supply chain which includes some activities such as purchasing, manufacturing, marketing, sales, and distributions. And then within that, that particular focal firm is connected with various other companies in tier one, tier two suppliers, or in going forward, tier one, tier two, tier three customers. And what happened in supply chain, we have a product flow that we know, we have a cash flow which goes backward. We have data flow that we are looking at, and there are other supporting companies. It's not about just manufacturing company which is making a product. There are other companies are also participating, and these days IT companies are becoming one of the key supporting firms. So this is the way we look at. In digital supply chain, the recent studies that I've done, I thought like where these particular technologies are being used. We are looking at some of the technology like production technology, 3D printing at manufacturing level is being used. Robotics are being used in that level. Then we look at across the supply chain, we have trace and track technologies that we can talk about. And then linking all these things, there is a platform that actually integrates all these information together, which is very similar to what Professor Tiwari was presenting. But at the end, on the top level, there's a big data analytics that we are actually observing. And then user interface technologies. And why actually all these digital technologies are being done is because companies have to make strategic decisions or tactical decision or operational decisions. So it links everything, it makes things more smoother. I'm not going to go into this digital architecture. If you get this slide, you will have all these different technology and where it fits into different decision making. You will see it. But what is the main challenge in digital supply chain that we don't understand? What data we need to actually capture from the supply chain or from manufacturing, and how these and which technology will be applicable in capturing that data, and even if we capture that data, what kind of decision one should make? And again, this is all these studies has been done through within the context of multinational organization. When we're looking at inclusive manufacturing, small and micro plant level manufacturing, as was mentioned before, then how this particular technology can be used in that context as well. So, to end my slide very quickly, how can inclusive manufacturing system be designed? That's the big question that we need to be asking, and to actually be from digital technology perspective, we understand digital supply chain has immense opportunities to promote inclusive manufacturing, provided we know what is inclusive manufacturing. Again, I'm going back to the first question. What are the requirements for inclusive manufacturing? What data is needed for running inclusive manufacturing? Where is this data is? How this data can be collected using digital technology, and how knowledge can be distributed? Because we are talking about people who doesn't have basic knowledge to run a kind of livelihood through manufacturing activities. So they have to be trained as well. So thank you very much.